the shark, babe, has such teeth, dear, and it shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Maggie Heath, babe, and it keeps it out of sight. You know when that shark bites with his teeth.
It's all about, you know, just how wonderful he was. I mean, he would come up just amazing to listen to the stories he had about, you know, his law practice and how it was in the 50s and in the 40s, and of course his war experience, you know, the things he did, you know, as a citizen. But you know, he's a great legal mind and just a terrific personality. I mean, I work with him hand in hand, you know, and with some of the local productions, like Night of the Iguanas, I recall, and it was just a real pleasure to know him. I mean, it's just an inspiration.
I heard those comments to the boys, and Troy Denton said, I love these guys almost as much as I love boys. I couldn't help but notice tonight, Dean might have on a boy's jacket. Not sure, but I believe he did. On the Easter Sunday morning at the First Baptist Church, we're going, boys came in, and he had on this absolutely disgusting yellow and green sport coat. On the Easter Sunday, and I'm standing in the boys, and he walks by me, and I'm speaking. So all that came to me was, I said, boys, you look like an Easter egg. He said, who told you you were looking pretty today?
My family and the Harmon family have had a close relationship for three generations. My father and boys, they belong to a mutual admiration society. They love each other. And they fought some tough battles against corruption down here. They both had assassination attempts on their lives. And as time went on, I had the great pleasure of working for boys. And after I left his employ, we became very close social friends. It was a time in my life when I had a card in my wallet that said, in case of emergency, please call Boyce Holloman, 961-304. I loved him.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling. Must go, and I must lie.